Breaking news right now at 11, a massive hotel fire in Fort Myers. Look at this brand new video of firefighters trying to save the Howard Johnson on US 41. Thank you for counting on NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Brenna Weick. NBC2's Megan Myers is live at the hotel right near Page Field. Megan, is this fire under control yet?
Well, fire crews are still working to make sure that they put out all of the flames, but things have definitely calmed down out here. But I actually want to introduce you guys to Jen and Eric. Jen was actually inside of this building when those flames first started. Jen, kind of walk us through everything that you saw, everything that you heard.
Well, I heard something. The siren sounded really close. So I opened my door and all you saw was fire trucks, smoke, everything, and I ran to grab my dog and like my laptop, belongings, stuff like that, and started running out, helped one of the ladies that's here that has dementia that wouldn't come out of her room, helped her, put her in my car so she would be safe, and then Eric just happened to be here checking on me, and he pulled in on the other side where the flames were shooting out.
Was going through your mind in that moment? You said you were worried, you know,
yeah,
making sure she was okay.
She was in class, so she just got back a little bit early tonight, so I saw the flames when I was driving by. I thought, oh, she's at school, I better go get her dog. So came up, I saw the flames, and then I was going to run into the office to see if I could get a key, but it was all smoked out, terrible smoke damage in the office. But fortunately, I started to go towards her room, and all of a sudden she came out with the dog, and all was well.
Yeah. What was going through your mind in that moment, you know, seeing, you said you stayed here for several months.
What went through your mind seeing the place that you've been staying go up in flames like that?
It was kind of crazy. I've been in a house fire before, so it was kind of wild to see that again. I don't know. It's more worrying about what's going to happen after the fact. If, you know, they're going to have to close down, what everybody's going to do, you know, nobody knows what's going to happen.
Are your belongings okay? Talk to us about everything.
Everything's still in my room.
So. And, you know, seeing this destruction, what's kind of going through your mind right now? I definitely feel like probably a lot of emotions.
Honestly, I don't know what to think. I don't know what to do. Like, we were thinking about getting another room, but they have my deposit. We don't really know what to do.
Definitely nothing you expect to happen. And kind of walk us through one more time. Those flames, we saw that video. They looked massive. What was that like for you to see that and be just steps away from a building that was burning down?
It was pretty wild. I mean, you know, like I said, I've been through a house fire when I was a child, but to see a huge commercial building, you know, on fire that much was pretty wild.
It was pretty surreal. It started in that second room right there.
Wow.
So, yeah, so all the flames just pouring out of that room.
Well, I'm so glad you guys are all okay.
Yeah. There's a man who ran out of that room. He said, oh, my stuff. So it's definitely his room. And he's pretty distraught.
Thank you guys so much for talking with us. And we're so glad you guys are okay. And you're so brave. And thank you so much. And, of course, NBC2 will be staying here on scene. And we'll keep you updated on any new information that we learn. I'm live right now in Lee County. Megan Myers, NBC2.